Hello everyone, I'm going to work on my black dot piece again, and I've sanded the sides, and in the right corner you can see the tool I used for it. It's a very small one. They also use it for nails, but it's also very good for small sharp edges. So I've linked it in the description box so you can check it out. And I already started with some masking tape to put on the back to prevent that I have drips on the back of my dot piece. So the whole back is going to be taped. And after that I make sure that the sides are very tight to the dot piece. There you can see it. I press it very tight to my resin. And after that I'm going to cut the excess away. And I thought I thought you would also want to see how I did this. That's why I also make a video of taping the back. So now with a sharp edge I'm going to cut away the excess of the tape. There you can see it all the way around. And also in this video you are going to see how I put the clear coat on. And also how I remove the tape, because I think you want to see that also, and the end result you are going to see in this video. And then it's all finished. But first, taping the back. There I show you the tape I use. It's from the same company as where I buy my resin. So it's especially made for working with resin. So it's almost done, and then I can go to the clear coat. So now I'm starting with the clear coat. I start in the middle. There you can see me pour the resin on top of it. You can also see some molds I have on the left side. And I got them just yet. And I'm very excited to use them. You're not going to see that in this video. That will be another video. But they are very nice. And I also will put the link of where you can buy those molds in the video. More resin on top of it. And I work my way from the inside to the outside. A little bit more heat to make it liquid, and with this coat it is protected against UV, because I'm using the stone coat art coat, and I've used the quick coat in different layers, but the quick coat doesn't have a UV blocker, so I needed to use the art coat. So now I push the resin to the sides so that it can flow over the sides. Because I sanded the sharp edge, so it needs to flow over the side, because then the resin will get shiny again. And it looks very good. Also the crystals I added, very nice. Now I'm working on the sides, that they are all covered with resin. Also the torch for the air bubbles. I use this torch several times, because the air bubbles will rise to the top. Again, working on the sides, a little bit more resin. And it sparkles a lot. It's very, very nice. The blinged gold and the black go very well together. And also the other metallic colors. Yeah, and before I can remove the tape, it needs to dry for 24 hours at least. Again, the torch for the air bubbles. And I also do this during drying process. So I'm almost done, and then we can go to removing the tape from the back. So it has dried for at least 24 hours. Now I'm going to start on removing the tape. I have some drops on the back, you can see that. And I have a piece of paper underneath it so that I don't get any scratches on it. Because it's not totally cured yet. So that's why I have a piece of paper underneath it. So first the larger pieces of masking tape. And I'm using a palette knife to get it loose. Now working on the sides. And it goes off very easy. Now I'm removing the smaller pieces I still have on the sides very carefully with the palette knife, because I don't want to make scratches. So I'm looking at the sides. There we have some pieces of masking tape, so I'm going to remove them. And I'm very glad with the middle, because the middle is shining through, so that was my goal. Only on the outside the black color, and in the middle clear. So the last pieces of masking tape. So almost done. Yeah, and it needs to come all off. I don't like it if there are small parts of tape still on the sides. So there it's done, and then we can go to the end result. So this is the end result. Again, I've placed it on a wooden stand, and yeah, I'm liking these colors together. They are so sparkly, and yeah, and also the crystals I've added, I'm very pleased with, and also the blinged gold and the black, it sparkles a lot. So a little bit closer, there you can see the smaller dots. And also the red crystals and the clear ones. Yes, I'm liking this piece. And it's so much fun to make these art pieces. Also the sides. There you can see it. I'm trying to show you the depth. It's very difficult to film. So if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up. All the links you want to know are in the description box, also from my Amazon store, also from the sander. I want to thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!